I'm about to go on a rather unusual tour of London. We are going to be shown not the Houses of Parliament and not the Buckingham Palace, but properties that belong to the oligarchs from the former Soviet Union.
One of the organizers of the tour is Vladimir Ashurkov, a former Russian banker who had to flee Russia and was granted asylum in Britain.
They bring money to Britain, they buy property. For years, our words, which we engaged with the British establishment, with the media, with the public, they were falling on deaf ears. We hope that this will change.
The tour takes us to one of the squares in central London, which has acquired a new unofficial name, the Red Square. So many Russian oligarchs have bought property here.
Like a lot of foreign billionaires, they have this bizarre view that Britain is run by the Queen and the royal family, the House of Lords. So they like to buy property close to the royal family.
Living close to the royal family in central London seems to bestow respectability. And sometimes it's even possible to buy a whole underground station. This one, the old Brompton Road tube station, was bought by a Ukrainian oligarch, Dmitry Firtash, for a mere £53 million. He bought it from the Ministry of Defence. This property is registered in Mr. Firtash's name, and there is no evidence that any of the money spent on it was laundered. But many of the properties are bought by anonymous offshore companies, and this opens a window for money laundering.
Three quarters of the properties being purchased are being purchased in secret. That's wrong. So it ought to be completely transparent. However, the government's going to do a consultation on this later in the year, and hopefully we'll change the legislation. The British Overseas Territories have got to be forced by the UK Parliament to stop having hidden companies.
In the meantime, property in central London is becoming unaffordable.
So this is modern Mayfair living.
This one in Mayfair has just been reduced to £6 million. Peter Wetherill, who has been in the estate agent's business for over 30 years, says that allegations of dirty money being spent by foreigners on property are without foundation.
It makes good television, but it's not in reality, it's not a practice. Uh-huh. You know, we are a very stable economic centre. You have bankers who have rules, you have lawyers who have rules, you have estate agents who have rules.
Perhaps when the rules are tightened more, we shall know who owns so much of London and some of the estates nearby.